Welcome to this new video. In this video, we will be discussing about how to find a given 16-bit data is a even number or a odd number. So to understand whether the given 16-bit data is a even number or odd number, let us first understand what do we mean by an even number and an odd number. So you all know that we are basically using the simple numbers like integers 0, 1, 2, 3, so on, so forth. Now, if the given number, okay, I assume the given number is some x, okay, if this number, okay, is divisible by 2, okay, and remainder is 0, then we say that the given number x is a even number. For example, suppose if I take 44, okay, I have to divide it by 2. So 2 is what? 2 into 2. Again, this number is divisible. So here what happens? 44 divided by 2 will give 22. 22 is what now? Here the remainder is what? 0. So that means what? The given number 42 is divisible by 2. So given number 44 is even. Okay, you take one more number, say 58. Okay, now you divide it by 2. So here you will get what? 29. So 29, what happened? Now here there is a remainder is again 0. So 58 again is a even number. So simple is what here? Any number if it is divisible by 2 and the remainder is 0, then we call that the given number is a even number. To find the number whether it is a odd number, the same principle can hold good. Let us assume the given number is y. So now this y should be divided by 2. Now here in this case what happens? Here the remainder will always be 1. There will be 1. So in that case what happens? We say that the given number y is an odd number. Now for example 37 divided by 2, you get what? 2 and 2, 8. So here you are getting what? 18, but again there is a remainder 1. Remainder is what? 1. So here 37 is not called a even number, it is a odd number. So 37 is what? Odd number. Similarly, if you take 157, then divide it by 2, what you will get? 2 sevens are 14, 1 will remain, 2 eights are 16. So here what happened? Again, you are getting one remainder. Remainder is what? 1. So we say that 157 is a odd number. Okay, this is simple mathematics. Now the same thing we can apply for in terms of hexadecimal numbers. Now we all know that in an ARM processor, we read the value of a 32-bit data, right? So we always represent it what 32-bit value in the form of like 0x11111. So these 4 bits are nothing but it is 16-bit data, and these 4 bits are nothing but next 16-bit data. So together it is nothing but a 32-bit data. Right now, internally this one is again a 4-bit data. So one is nothing but 0001. Right now, see, to understand this 16-bit given number is a even or odd. Now let us take an example of one value 0 1 1 1 0. Okay, now see, this is my 32-bit value, but I am interested in only this 16-bit value. So internally, what is this? 1 is nothing but, it is nothing but 0000, then 0001, then again 0001, again 0001. Okay. Now, whether to find the given number is an odd or an even number, see here. Now, what we have to do is, you need to just rotate it to the right. Okay, when you rotate it, your LSB bit value will be pushed into the carry. Okay, now see, I'll enter these values here. All my 16 bit data 0000, that is 0001. First value 0, okay, 0001, then 0001, then 0001. Now, when I say the instruction rotate right, what happens? This bit will be pushed to carry. Okay, and the same value will be pushed to your bit number 31. Okay, now I can use the condition, that is branch on carry instruction. Okay, branch instruction in short. Okay, now see here. Well, how to identify whether the given number is odd or even? Basic on this. Now, if I take a simple value 2, 2 is written what? 0011. Now you know that 2 is a even number and 3 is an odd number. So if you just identify the LSB bit positions here. Okay, LSB bit position. See, for an even number, it is always ending with 0. And for odd number, it always end with 1. That is, your LSB bit value will be what? Either 0 or 1. So, on the basis of that bit, you can say that whether the given number is an odd number or an even number. Now, for even number, it is compulsory that the LSB bit value should be 0. And for odd number, the LSB bit value should be 1. So on this particular rule, we can just simply say that whether this number is a even or a odd number. Now currently, since I have taken 1 here, that is my carry bit is currently having 1. That means 1 is what indicates that the given number is a odd number. I'll say that this number is now what? My odd number. Now similarly here, you can see here, now a different example, I take 0001100110. Now if I represent it here again, I'll just consider only the lower 16 bit, 0000, then 0001, then again 0001, 0000. Okay, when I use my rotate instruction, what happened? 0 is going to pushed into your carry bit. Now I'll check whether the carry flag is 0 or 1. Now here the carry flag is 0. So that means what? This 0 indicates what now? It's a even. So that means my given number 0110 0110 is nothing but is a even number. So this is a simple. Here in the instruction, what you are going to do is in the program, you are going to just use one instruction, that is ROR. Just by using this one instruction, you will be able to indicate whether the given number is an even or a odd number. Okay. Since you know that you are reading a 32-bit data, see that the higher order, higher 16-bit data. 16-bit data is a dummy value. Okay, you can basically use like 0x0000, then your actual value. Actual value. Right, now we are considering only 16 bit, so we have to take only 16-bit data. You can also perform the operation of masking, which you have done in your counting the zeros and ones. If you want to go in that way, that is also possible. But I suggest you to use this simple method wherein you can use only one instruction, that is rotate right. So on the basis of LSB positions, we will be able to indicate whether the given number is a even number or a odd number. Okay. Now, this is the fundamental how to identify. So, how you are going to display it? Here we cannot display the value. So, we can take two registers. Okay. Like R2 and R3. In R2, you store the number 1. Okay. This indicates what? It indicates the number is odd. Okay. And when you increment R3 by 1, it indicates that the given number is even. So here, if at the end of the experiment, you will be able to know what is the value of R3 and R2. If the value of R2 is 0 and R3 is 1, that means the given number is even. Okay. If suppose R3 is 0 and R2 is 1, then the given number is, that is, okay. So let us check how this 16 bit data is even and odd by our experiment. Okay. Now let us check how to execute the program. Now you can see here that I have to write the name for the program. So I'll write here what area name is like even and odd. Even odd. And since the code is written in a read-only memory, so it is code and read-only. Okay, then we indicate the start of the execution. Okay, then start. Now see, as I already told, I need to take two registers just to indicate whether the given number is a even number or a odd number. So here I have taken R2 for odd number, so I'll indicate odd number, and R3 for a even number, so I'll indicate even number. Then I need to read that particular value. So here initially what I have done, I have taken some values, that is 1111110. That means my lower 16 bit value is 1110. So in the last bit it is what? 0. So it means I can easily say that the given number is a even number. Let us check whether it is given to you accurately or not. Now see, I have read the value, that is its address in R7. Then what I am going to do is, since I am going to read the value only once, I have taken a counter R7 which is going to read the value. Okay, then in R6 its address, that is the value of this, okay, address of this value in R6. From R6 I need to add 4 and to get the actual data, that is load your register value into R0 from R6 plus 4. So the value of that will be loaded into R0. Now whatever the value, this value will be stored in R0. This value I am going to move it by using the move instruction, that is by rotate also. So here move s R0 comma R0 rotate right. Okay, rotate right by one position. I am not going to do it once or twice, it is only once. So then what I am going to do is, I am going to check the carry bit flag. Now this is going to indicate whether the carry is 1 or not. Here this condition is going to satisfy when the carry bit is 1. So branch on instruction, that is if the carry bit is 1, it goes to your odd loop, and if it is 0, it goes to the next instruction. Now currently it is what? The value is 0. So 0 means this instruction will not get executed, it will go to here. So I need to indicate R3 by 1. So I am going to do what? I am going to increment R3, or simply I'll add 1 to R3. So add R3 comma R3 plus 1. So you will be getting R3 as 1. Then when it is 1, then you need to go to this. Okay, right. So here, when you are using E1, okay, what happens? You are going to go into the next odd instruction. So you said you have to use branch. This I don't want, so I'll just remove it. Tell here, indicate. Here it will come. Okay, and it will use what a breakpoint. Now if suppose the value is 1 at this point, that means what happens here, it will go to the OR and it will increment R2, and it will use indicate that the given number is a odd number. Now let us see with the execution here. Now see, initially all my registers values are 0, as well as my carry pick flag. Now R2 is 0, R3 is 0. So I'll execute once. Now see, R2 is 0 here, then R3 is 0, then R7 I need to indicate just to count only once. So I have taken a counter for that R7. Okay, then I am going to load the value of R section. Okay, now R6, that is address of that particular value. So this R6, now this I need to add 4, then store it in R1. Now as soon as I execute this instruction, here you will get the value of this, whatever the data is present. So here you are getting, see, R0 11 11 11 10. Okay, now on this I need to rotate it. So I am going to rotate it once. So as soon as you rotate, what happens? Carry bit is 0, because the value itself is 0, means you are not getting any change here. Now 0 is there, so 0 indicates what? It is a even number. So here it is going to check whether the carry bit flag is 0 or 1. Now currently the carry bit flag is 0. So as soon as you indicate, what happens? It has to go to the E1 part. So see, this condition failed. So it is going to E1 part. So next, you need to add on E1 number, that is register R3. So I am going to add 1 to R3. Initially it is 0, now it becomes 1. Okay, then if I didn't use this loop, unconditional branch loop, then what happens? It will go here. So I have used a branch loop to exit, because I have completed my task. Okay, now at the end of the program, what happened? Now R3 is indicating 1. That means what? It is interpreted like the given value is a even number. Okay, now let us check for a odd number. Now I'll just change the value here, 1. Okay, you can change these values also. Okay, I am going to check 0. Even if you don't use this instruction, this also doesn't make any matter. That is the counter for reading the values. Save, rebuild, rebuild. Now see, now I have taken 1. Now I know that it is a odd number. Let us check it. Now run. Again R2 becomes 0, R3 is 0. Then your carry flag. Here initially carry flag is 0. Next R6 value. Okay. then load the value address and value of that particular data. And 1101, that is right in this R0. Now I am going to rotate it. See, as soon as I rotate, what happened? In carry, 1 has come up. Now I have to check whether the carry bit is 1 or 0. So I have used this branch instruction. Okay, now it has to compulsively go to the order loop. Now it has to successfully execute this instruction. So as soon as I execute, what happened? It went into the odd loop. So here you need to add R2 by 1. So R2 is added by 1. After that, you have to break, use your breakpoints. So here, see, at the end of the execution, what happened? R2 is 1. That means what? Now the given number is a odd number and R3 is 0. So here you are looking two registers, R2 and R3. In whichever register you are having 1, that indicates whether the given number is odd or even. So here I have taken R2 for an odd number and R3 for an even number. So this is how we are going to detect whether the given 16-bit data is a even number or odd number. Thank you.